When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing Vita Bella. Hearts will play tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay, like a guitarandella. When the stars make you drool, just like a pastifazool, that's amore. When you dance down the street with a cloud at your feet, you're in love. When you walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, signore. Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore.
That's amore.
Bells will ring.
Ding-a-ling-a-ling.
On the Isle of Capri that I found her, beneath the shade of an old walnut tree. Oh, I can still see the flowers blooming around her, where we met on the Isle of Capri. She was as sweet as a rose at the dawning, but somehow fate hadn't met her for me. And though I sailed with the tide in the morning, still my heart's on the Isle of Capri. Summertime was nearly over, blue Italian sky above. I said, lady, I'm a rover, can you spare a sweet word of love? She whispered softly, it's best not to linger. Then as I kissed her hand, I could see wore a lovely meatball on her finger. 'Twas goodbye at the Villa Capri.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Hi, everyone. My name is John Hartman, and on behalf of the organizing committee for Paul's Pasta Party, we would like to extend a wonderful thank you and welcome to everybody here tonight. We have an awful lot of things in store for you. As you've seen already, we've got some wonderful silent auction items. There'll also be draws. We're going to be holding raffles. There's going to be a live auction with some really, really nice prizes, NHL tickets, and well, I won't give too much away. In the meantime, the bar is open. Help yourselves. Enjoy yourself this evening. And we'll be starting in a few minutes with some live entertainment. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, for your listening enjoyment, may I present Andrea and Sam, No Shugs.
Oh,
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Paul's Pasta Party! Hey! Paul, I love you, buddy. Andrea, kids, it's so great to see you. And just before we get things going, I just want to say, first of all, thank you to all of you for being here. And we all know, dude, look how many people are here, man. What you'd think that Brad Pitt had shown up in Coppercliff to film a movie or something. What the heck's going on here? We all know that you love this man, and we thank you for being here. But one very, very important note, we just want to let you know. Obviously, so many of you maybe haven't seen them in a while. Paul is, of course, undergoing treatment right now, so it's really, really important that we keep any type of infection away that could be there. So instead of shaking hands, kissing him, hugging him, we know what a hugger he is, and we know he loves that. But if you can just blow him a kiss and wave hi to him tonight as you see him, just so that we can avoid that.
And grab my ass if they want.
And grab his ass as well. I didn't want to say it out loud. I know that he loves it, but it's good. He's breaking down the walls right now. For those of you that do not know me, my name is Jim Silva, and I am, thank you very much. I am very honored to be your master of ceremonies tonight. I wanted to let you know quickly about the way that Paul and I met, because it is quite an interesting story. We were both students at St. Charles College back in 19... And at the time, I was a grade 9 student running for second vice president of the St. Charles Student Council. Paul was up in the rafters with the rest of the boys at St. Charles. And I thought, you know what, I'm not just going to get up there and do a regular old speech. I'm going to try and entertain the people. You know, they don't know who I am. I'm in grade 9, so what have I got to lose? So I got that up there, and as part of my speech, I did an impersonation of one of the teachers at St. Charles College, which pretty much went over like a lead balloon. And all of a sudden, there's this commotion from the rafters, and all of a sudden, there's two guys dragging Falcioni down onto the ground to the stage. Unbeknownst to me, Paul was very well known for doing this impersonation of this certain teacher, Mr. Ron Kelly. And let's just say he schooled me. Put me to shame with that impersonation. And everybody laughed, and I lost the election, and that was that. So, years later, as the years went on, we, you know, had a lot of mutual friends, and we got to be good friends. And Paul and Andrea used to come down to the Trevi, where I used to do some karaoke down there. And one of his favorite songs was a tune by Macy Gray. So, Paul, I'd like to do that for you now.
Yeah. Games, changes, and fears. When will they go from here? When will they stop? I believe that fame has brought us here, and we should be together, Paul, but we're not. I play it off like I'm dreaming of you. I keep my cool, but I'm fading. Try to think.
Okay, you get the point. Okay. That's for you, good guy.
Marmalade.
You know, maybe we'll get to the Lady Marmalade a little later on. I'll have to get a couple in me, you know what I mean? So, and of course, Paul and the kids were big fans of the show. I used to do a morning show on a station called Big Daddy 103.9 years ago, and And Paul used to call in, he used to email me and stuff like that. So I'm just, like I said, I'm just absolutely tickled pink to be here tonight, and it's an absolute honor. We are gonna have an amazing evening. We've got so many great things planned for you. Wanna thank Andrea and Sam for providing us with the wonderful music tonight. Thank you so much to them. And of course, as you know, the reason that we're all here is we are going to be raising a lot of money to support Paul and Andrea and the kids. And we've got so many ways that you can do that tonight. Of course, the raffle tickets that are going around. Dan Bronicheski and Paul Bravo, they'll be going around the hall selling the tickets. We've got two different raffle items up for grabs. A 42-inch Sony Bravia flat screen TV and the Legostina pot set. Did I say that okay? Lagostina? Faremo una festeggiola domani sera, spero veramente che possa venire. I have no idea what I just said. Sure, I went to Italy back in 85, picked up a little Berlitz book, you know. Found a few phrases, thought they might help me out. Si tolgi i pantaloni e le mutande, right? Is that right? Right? Please take off your pants and shorts. It was in the doctor's office section, but I thought it might come in handy. So the tickets for those, it's $5 for one, three for $10. So, duh, the $10, it's a better deal. Yes, sir?
46-inch TV.
40, well, then you should be buying like 20 tickets, right?
Yes.
You heard Dan. Size does matter.
He should know he's got four kids.
We also want to say a very special thank you to all of the sponsors who helped, you know, donate these fabulous items. So many great people. We've got people like CompuTrack that were donating items. Anyways, we've got a big sponsor board. So please check out the names of the sponsors. We're going to be telling you a little bit more about them as the evening goes on. And help support these guys, you know, in their businesses because they're all fabulous people. Also, a special thank you to the Italian Club and the staff here. They are graciously donating their time and the hall tonight. Amanda and the crew who donated their time and all the terrific decor we have here tonight. This looks so nice. And of course, to all our entertainers that are gonna be here tonight donating their time and talent. And one other thing we also do want to make sure that we remind you of is to please drink and drive responsibly. So, a night like this, it doesn't just happen, right? There's so many people and a very special crew that was able to bring this together. So I'd like to introduce that committee that was instrumental in putting this together tonight. Friends of Paul and Andrea's, Brian and Joanne Tramontini. The 46-inch man, Dan Bronicheski. John and Cindy Hartman. Paul Barbo and family members. The Brochacho Nacho, Mike Falcioni. And his lovely wife, Patty. Their daughter, Jennifer Falcioni, and Paul's sister-in-law, Natalie Falcioni. Great stuff. And actually, I would like to bring one of those members up right now. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome John Hartman.
Thank you, Jim. Thanks for oh yeah, you're way up here, that's right. Paulie.
John.
How you doing?
You look like your dad with those glasses.
Hi, everybody. My name is John Hartman. There he is. I go back quite a ways with Paul. As many of us do. We met at the ripe old age of about 14 as we were both entering St. Charles College for the first time. And let's just say since then we've found more than a few ways of getting in trouble together. And well, there's one that I'd be remiss if I didn't bring up tonight very quickly. And Mom, by the way, we were of age when I tell this story, okay? because it was a nice summer evening. And by the way, I'll also be referring to somebody that you might remember by the name of Tuska. Yeah. Ben. So Paul and I had a really good time the night before. We're probably at the president or something like that. And the next day, Paul was licking his wounds on Arvo Street at the Falcioni's house. So I decided to join him, and we're in rough shape. Imagine what kind of lack of concentration you've got when Paul's got the Home Shopping Network on the television in front of him, okay? So we're not paying attention to much, all right? Now, to Scott, whenever he'd come home and some of the friends were over, he'd see our cars there. He'd come in, he'd say, "Hey, you guys are downstairs? I'm Mr. Falcioni, hi Dad," and we know he's home, right? So here we are just half-baked, just licking our wounds, and we perk up a little bit because on this Home Shopping Network television, we hear the announcer say, "We now have a wonderful pair of cubic zirconia earrings. And our first caller today is Ben from Sudbury." And we go, there's a guy from Sudbury that's on the, and we're watching this, and there's a guy calling from Sudbury? So I said to Paul, I said, "Do you know a Ben from Sudbury?" And Paul's like, I can't think of it right now. So as that's going on, we then hear the announcer say, "Ben, for your chance at these beautiful earrings, in the next 60 seconds, you have to ring a bell." And we're thinking that then Paul starts to actually laugh. He got that part of it. He's like, "Oh, this guy's going to be like a gong show. This is crazy." There's this thunderous rush comes down the stairs, and it's Tuska. And he runs right by us, doesn't even look at us. And if anybody remembers from Arvo Street, at the end of the bar bell, he grabs his barbell, he starts ringing that bell, goes running past us, ringing it all the way up the stairs. Paul and I are there like this. Because again, for the first time in forever, Mr. Falcioni hadn't let us know he came home. We didn't know he was home upstairs, watching the Home Shopping Network. So anyhow, yeah, I think from that point on, it was about a month before Paul and I ever had a beer again. It was kind of rough. So those kinds of memories, we all definitely look forward to making many more fond memories with Paul for a long time to come and with the family. And once again, on behalf of the committee, the organizing committee for tonight, thank you all so very much for making this a success that it's going to be. And now, I would like to hand the microphone over to somebody special by the name of Natalie Falcioni.
Yep. Thank you, everybody, for coming this evening. It is quite overwhelming, but on behalf of the Falcioni families, especially Paul, Andrea, and Dante and Grace, we want to thank you from the bottom of our hearts, and thank you for your generosity, your support, and your love and your prayers. We truly appreciate it. We want you to have a blast tonight, okay? Yeah. I would like to call, we have a special presentation, and I would like to call Grace Falcioni up. She has a few things she wants to say. I think she takes after me. No, her noni.
Come on, this whole god.
Hi, everybody. John. Thank you so much for coming. This really means a lot to my family and I. I'm up here to show you something very special that I've made for my dad, and I would like to share it with you. I've worked very hard on this, and I would like to thank Auntie Natalie for letting me use all her art supplies and her house to do this. And as you can see, there's like words. And it's a poem I wrote for my dad, and it's called What Makes My Dad Dad. What makes my dad dad is when he tells me jokes. I always laugh. What makes my dad dad is the things he calls me. Hey, poops, or you're a pickle. What makes my dad dad is his positive attitude. He always has a smile. What makes my dad dad is how he loves us and how we love him. He's the best dad in the whole world. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Grace. Absolutely beautiful. And now, once more, I would like to call up John and Cindy Hartman.
Hi, everybody. How many of you watch the CBC television series Battle of the Blades? Pretty good show, eh? Pretty good. For those of you that don't know, it's kind of like a Dancing with the Stars, but instead of actors and dancers, it's female figure skaters and male hockey players. And they do that beautiful dance together. So we know that Paul and Andre and the Falcionis really enjoy the series. And it happens that a little blonde bird that, who's part of our committee also knows, she actually knows Brian Savage, who happens to be one of our local guys who's on the show this year and doing really well. He's paired together with a world class and Olympic skater, Jessica Dubé. And they're paired together for the season. And when my wife Cindy talked to Brian's little sister, Cheryl, and explained what was going on tonight, whatnot, Cheryl then said, well, I've got to tell Brian. And of course, once Brian got wind of it, he ended up thinking, well, we should maybe send something up to a couple of our favorite viewers. So he wanted to make sure from now on that both Paul and Andrea wear the official Team Savage and Team Dubé t-shirts. Paul's, yours is the big one.
I thought you were going to say the other color one.
Well, you can bring that up with Brian Savage at a later date, okay?
Very nice.
And then on top of that, as well to go along with that, Brian wanted to make sure to send them all an official Battle of the Blades autographed portrait of their team, of Brian Savage and Jessica Dubé.
Oh,
and there we go.
It's just your color, buddy. Fantastic. All right, I know you can smell that fantastic food, can't you? But we got to do one more thing before we get to the food, and that is we're going to call up the very lovely and the very talented Claire Falcioni to say grace before meals for us.
Mother-in-law, mother-in-law. You better pull me back. Or just push me back. My mother-in-law's coming. Look out. Okay, that's good. Thanks. Mother-in-law.
I have to do it.
Hey, Ashley.
Do you need a microphone?
Never. You love me, Kirkwood?
Sure do.
Don't bother standing because the tables are too close. Just bow your heads, please, for a minute. God bless the food we're about to eat and those who prepared it. Bless us, O Lord, and these thy gifts, which we are about to receive from thy bounty, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Claire and I used to sing together in the choir a long time ago. You should hear her do Macy Gray. It's a heck of a lot better than mine. All right, so it is time to dig into the fabulous food. We are going to get you to come up here. And I decided that I'm going to do this by picking out my favorite people, and their tables will go first. And of course, hey, Musso, relax. Just take it easy over there. All right, so we've got, how we're going to do it is we're going to start right here with, oh, you know it, Gracie. I love you too. We are going to start, and this is table 14, so they're going to come up first. And then, after they're done grabbing their food, we're going to get table 15 over here to come up. And quite simply, we're just going to alternate back and forth as we go. So table 14, come on up, grab yourself a plate, dig in. And ladies and gentlemen, enjoy your meal. Just one other thing, if you would like a vegetarian sauce, so a non-meat sauce if you are a vegetarian, just please request that when you come up and we'll make sure that we get one of those for you. Awesome. She's going to be coming up a little later on, but oh my gosh. How about a big hand for Leah Tramontini, ladies and gentlemen? Wow. You know what? I'm making a prediction right now. You guys, when you see her on TV accepting her first Juno Award, you're gonna go, I saw her at Paul's pasta party. You're awesome. Great stuff, and we're gonna hear more from her later on. All right, it's time now to do the draws for the door prize. We have 15 items up for grab. I'm gonna ask Cindy Hartman to come and pick up the door prize box, which has all of the ballots. And I'm gonna ask the Falcioni family to help us out. All right, so our first door prize is for a $125 gift basket for Verdicchio's. Paul is reaching in there, pulling out the first name. And it's Lara Hollett, Paul's niece. Congratulations, Lara. You got the Verdicchio gift basket. Thank you. All right, item number two is a $50 Cortina Pizza gift certificate.
Oh, hey.
Hey.
I want to win that.
Love the kitchen sink, Paul. And the winner is Kayla Bronicheski. Way to go, Kayla.
Hey, Paul, don't eat pizza.
Our next item is a $75 hand-carved wooden box. Kayla, you can come on up and grab your prize. Paul's got the next one. And the winner is Ken Rappel.
Ropel.
See, I'm going to do this all night long. I'm so sorry. Ken Ropel.
It's okay, Jim.
Congratulations.
It's okay, Jim.
As long as you have forgiven me, that's all I need, big boy. Our next item is a $25 Ital Pasta gift box. And the big winner is... Mary Tamalini, congratulations, Mary. The winner of the Ital Pasta gift box. Come on up and claim your prize. And we're gonna have all the items up here at this main table, so that's where you can come and get it. Up next we have, an Amsterdam Brewery gift bag. $50 value. Fantastic.
Chubby, how are you?
How are you?
Not bad. I wanted the Cortina thing. Chubby. Damn it.
The Amsterdam Brewery gift bag goes to Evangeline Cowie. Evangeline, congratulations. And the next item is a hurricane lamp and some note cards and a photo album. It's worth $75, and that is going to, as Paul pulls out another name, it's Josh Campbell. Very exciting. Way to go, Josh. Paul, you're doing a great job there, bud. I like the wrist action. It's, I don't know if it's the pink shirt that you got earlier, but. The next item, worth $85, is a Catelli Team Canada hockey shirt and a weather station. And that is going to It's Cleta Tramontini. Woo! Very, very nice. Hurricane lamp. Like those. And item number 8 is another $25 Ital pasta gift box. And that is Marcia Antoniazzi. Marcia. Antoniazzi. An Ital pasta gift box for Marcia, valued at $25. Congratulations. The door prize is an Afghan and a Skater's Edge skate sharpening, valued at $80. Great for all you skaters that want to bundle up after your skating is done. And the winner is Doug Christia. Doug, congratulations. And the winner of this item is Peter Stefanuto. Peter Stefanuto, congratulations. I know. The Ital pasta gift set. All right, we're down to the last two items. Next is for a $50 Cortina pizza box gift. And the winner is Ronnie Falcioni. Ronnie, hey! You got it, mon ami. And going to the Trevi will be Patty Rondina. Way to go, Patty. Happened because of the generosity of so many people, including Lori Lucian, the Stratford Festival, Sun Life Financial, Molson's, Brian Burrow, many other people. Again, we've got a sponsor board. Check those out and make sure you support those people. Now, we've got a live auction that's going to be going on a little later on, but we also, of course, have our silent auction, this amazing table with all of these gifts. And we are going to be closing that down, one half of the table, at 8 o'clock. So one half of this table is going to be shut down at 8 o'clock, so we're getting close to that time. You're going to want to make sure you keep an eye on those bids. I see a couple of people, they keep going up. You're going to want to keep an eye. And at this time, I'd like to call on Ann Ropel. Where's Ann? If Ann could come up, and we've got a little something that she's gonna deliver to you guys.
Good evening, everyone. It's so nice to see everyone here. I am Ann Falcioni Ropel, Paul's older but much better looking sister. I have a letter here for Paul and Andrea and the family, and it was sent from a very dear friend of mine, Laura Tenenforesto, who lives in British Columbia and who is a representative for Lagostina Cookware. She was instrumental in the donation of the pots and pans that are going to be raffled off later on. So we'd like to thank Karanko Lagostina for that very generous donation. So Paul, here's the letter from Laura. Hi, Paul. I remember meeting you 40 years ago at the Falcioni kitchen table at 1351 Arvo Street. You were all expressive brown eyes and a blur of movement, and your mouth never stopped moving. Yak, 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 yak. So it is with this in mind that Karanko Lagostina felt it appropriate that someone share good times with a commercial 13-piece Lagostina set. Mama Tanun used to call this kitchen table wisdom. People cooking, eating, discussing problems and happy occasions. You didn't need a psychiatrist. Simply put, you shared your happiest, saddest, and most personal stories, recipes, and lessons around the kitchen table. Mama used to say that good friends were endless conversations over good food and wine. I agree with her. I can pick up the phone anytime and speak with your sister Annie. The conversation resumes like we're chatting over a cup of tea or coffee. In my mind's eye, I look out at this crowd tonight and see all your happy, shiny faces. I want each and every one of you to look at those to the left and to the right of you and know that for one joyful evening, you are a testimonial to your love for Paul, Andrea, Dante, and Grace. Your being here makes a difference. Well, Paul and Andrea, I couldn't be here, but I would like to start off some raffling for you and the family. I'm sending you a crisp $100 bill to be used on the raffle items. Andrea already has that $100 bill in a secret hiding spot. I love you, and I would like all of you, I'm not going to ask you to stand, we're too crowded, but all of you to raise your glasses and say, we love you, Paul. To friendship and unending conversations, love from Laura, Tanun Forrestal and family, Port Coquitlam, British Columbia. Thank you.
Wow. Thank you so much, Anne. A fantastic message. So again, we've got that up for the raffle and that 46-inch TV. So Paul Barbeau, Dan Bronicheski, they're walking around. They're selling those tickets. Get them and get lots of them because those are two amazing prizes. Don't forget one more time, the silent auction, one half of the table will be shutting down at 8 o'clock, and then we will be announcing the winners. So make sure you get up there and bid. And, ladies and gentlemen, one more time, please give it up for the amazing Leah Tramontini. Well, if you weren't in love with her before, you've certainly fallen in love with her now. Ladies and gentlemen, one more huge round of applause, Leah Tramontini. Wow, she's gonna be a huge star. So great. Now, I know I told you we were gonna close the silent auction table at 8, but we're actually gonna shut it down right now. Hi, Connie. How are you, dear? We are going to shut it down a little bit early because we want to give Paul a chance to go around. He hasn't seen the items yet, so he's going to take a little trip around the table. So if you could do us a favor and maybe just return to your seats just so that we're able to get Paul around the table. He definitely wants to take a look at these items. So we are closing it right now, and at 8 o'clock we're going to be back. And I'm gonna get Natalie to come up and we are gonna announce the winners. And there's some fabulous dessert up here too. So again, Paul is just making his way around the table. He's checking out all the fabulous items that were donated tonight. Again, we thank all of our sponsors who donated these items, making this night possible. And once he's come around, we're going to let you know who won the first half of the silent auction.
They look like bed sheets or Metro? Oh, look at Heather and May. Oh, my God.
Just want to take this opportunity to thank a few more of our sponsors tonight. Help make this night possible. Bristol Machines, Reliable Maintenance, Ice Drum Media, Real Canadian Superstore, Discount Golf,
5 to 30 minute sessions in the world,
the Family Vision Center, so many more people. Thank you again. Make sure you go out and support these people.
Oh,
Oh, that's Brian's.
Oh, God, we're going to be hanging in this corner for a while.
Hey, I do. No kisses. Hey, Jim, nice to see you. I can't touch hands. Oh, I don't supposed to touch hands. Take care, Eve. Take care. The stick. Look at Lucio. Lucio's been on George's stick. That's what you got to get for when you're older.
Yeah.
The sticks that George. Hey, Ben. You got your smart served. Oh, geez, I want that.
Yeah, there, Brian autographed it for you. Yeah. It's at the back.
Is that
Yeah, Brian Savage signed that. Too.
But is that?
Montreal Canadiens.
Is that on the, what do you call it? Is that on the silent auction?
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, one thing that we forgot to mention to you was that on your tables, there's several white pieces of paper. We got one being held up right here. So there's square pieces of paper. There's some pens on the table. Those are for you to jot down your thoughts, any jokes, stories, anything you want to share with Paul. And then we're going to put it all in a big scrapbook for him. Some of them may have some pasta sauce on them right now. That's okay. We've got extra. But it might be a nice little touch if we got a little tomato sauce in there, right? So yeah, take your time, jot some notes down, and we're gonna gather those up later on. Thanks.
Excuse me. Oh my God. Hey,
I'm gonna put down.
Which?
I'm gonna put $400 down and put George's name beside it.
Which one is it? The painting?
Yeah.
That's from a girl I went to school with.
Yeah.
Cynthia Duchamp. She paints. Norman. How are you? How are you? Holy shit, this is cool. Can I bid on that? No, I guess not. Look at the painting. It's a speaker. It's a Bose. It's a Bose system. Look at this. That's from Cynthia. I saw that one. I saw that one. Gorgeous painting. Gorgeous painting. Tommy's not here. I'm sure his wife wants that. Mac! That guy!
Can I please have a relative or friend of Evangeline Cowie to come to the right-hand side of the stage over here? Evangeline Cowie?
Well, thank you for coming. Thank you.
Oh, that's Margie.
No, Paul's getting his dance friend, Margie. Are you? I'm creepy. She's creepy, creepy. Yeah, you're creepy, creepy.
Do you want some?
I'm cut in line. I want to go around again.
Are you kidding me?
Well, I just want to go to the tables. I can go myself.
Watch. What are you doing?
I can go myself.
You're gonna
just let me go myself for a little bit. I need to.
Okay.
I suppose you want me to move.
Yeah, get the hell out of the way.
Yeah, probably.
Crazy Ukrainian.
Well, why didn't you say so?
Well, I'm in the Italian club, so I have to say something. Hey, Al. Excuse me. Claire. Oh, I need to get by.
Oh, Bello.
Sorry. Thanks.
Do you want the mother-in-law to
You can't throw that poor boy in jail. How are you guys doing? Look at the wine on this table. Way to go, guys.
Yep.
You're making me proud.
Right
while
here.
You're drinking. Oh, I think how are things?
Good.
That's good. Hey, thanks for the donation, by the way. Thanks for the donation.
Am I a winner?
No, I'm not running this. It's not my show. It's not my shit show. We're just here for fun.
How are you doing right now?
And the paparazzi is all over.
I know. You're like a star.
It's like a big star.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Ours is a star. It comes out at night. So you guys came up all the way for this thing here. That's
Wouldn't miss it, man. Come on. I think that was like a big inspiration.
Ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've all been waiting for, please welcome for the silent auction first half, Natalie Falcioni.
Okay, everyone, here we go. Listen for your name. When your name is called, please just kind of flag somebody down. I have some runners here who are going to go to the table.
Hey.
And escort you to the back of the room in the reception area where you came in. You'll be able to pay for your item. We take cash and check, debit, MasterCard, and Visa. Okay, here we go. First item, the handcrafted oak wooden memory box. The winning bidder is Bridget Karonovich. The next item is the NHL goalie masks, framed rink, and the winning bidder is Patty Rondina. Patty Rondina.
Watch. Yeah, watch the court, guys. Do you go find Patty Rondina?
Faith Ropel.
Little girl.
The next item is the Chocolate Lovers Chocolate and Cutting Board. And the winning bidder is Ms. Bernard. Maisel Bernard?
Maisie?
Maisie, I'm sorry. Maisie Bernard. Where's Maisie?
I know.
Okay. The The next item is the Blu-ray DVD player and movie. The Blu-ray DVD player and movie, and the winning bidder is Nathan Falcioni. Nathan Falcioni. There's Nathan.
Thanks, buddy.
The next item is a queen size microfiber sheet set, two sets queen size, and the winning bidder is Shauna Lear. Shauna Lear. We have another set, a one set queen size sheet set. The winner is Ralph Falcioni. Ralph Falcioni. The next item is the Blissful Romance Basket with the prime rib gift certificate and the movie theater and wine. That's item number 30. Blissful Romance Basket goes to Deborah Moxham.
I know who she is. You do.
The next item is queen size microfiber sheets, two sets of them. The winning bidder is Donna Tremontini. Donna Tremontini. Donna, where's Donna? Yeah. Donna Tremontini, there she is. The next item is a handmade birchwood bowl. The handmade birchwood bowl. The winning bidder is Dan Sove. Dan Sove. Thank you very much, everyone. We'll be drawing for the second half very shortly, along with the raffle items.
A little later on tonight, we're going to have not only our live auction, but also the winners of the second half of the silent auction. We've still got raffles to do, so much more fun to have. Right now, want to introduce you to one of Sudbury's most talented and well-known musical artists. He is generously donating his time and his talents to tonight's event. Just such an amazing man. He's got a great wife too. Oh, yeah. You gotta plug Nini too. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jeff Wiseman.
Thank you, thank you. I'm going to start with a serious song and then just play some stuff that you would have heard me play back in the days of Casey's.
Yeah.
It's like a reunion here tonight. Seeing lots of folks who used to come out.
When I'm down and know my soul so weak, when troubles come and my heart burden be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. Raise me up so I can stand on mountains. Raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulder. Raise me up to more than I can carry. Before I run in the mood for a melody, and you gotta speak. Bars a friend of mine gets me my drinks free, and it's probably the joke or the light of the smoke, but there's some place in here I'd be.
Just getting better and better. Jeff's going to be back a little later on as well. And just before we get to the raffle and the live auction, I also just want to say a thank you to my buddy Richard Bilo, who's our official photographer, walking around tonight, taking snaps. There he is at the back. Thank you, Richard. All right, so we are going to be doing the raffle. The raffle tickets right now. That is for the 46-inch Sony Bravia flat-screen TV and the Lagostina pot set. So if you want to find your tickets, and I believe Natalie is coming up to help me out with the draws. Thank you so much again for buying the raffle tickets. So we're going to start with the 46-inch Sony TV.
What color is that one?
And that's the blue ticket for the TV. Everybody who's got a blue raffle ticket for the TV, get those ready to go. Listen to it. What's he saying? What?
He's saying do it in an accent so nobody will understand the numbers.
Do it in an accent?
Yes.
All right, so is that good, Paul? The winning ticket number is 699133. I hear some screams. I hear some screams. Somebody's realizing they have the winner, 133, right over here. We have got a winner. Congratulations. The proud owner of a 46-inch Sony Bravia. My gosh, you can watch The Walking Dead on that tomorrow night. Oh, the zombies coming at you in high def. Outstanding. And that means that up next is the draw for the Lagostina pot set. This thing is fantastic. You too can be like Giada De Laurentiis cooking in these pots. And the winning number is 6830. 130 right over here. Congratulations, we have got another big winner. The Lagostina pot set. Oh my gosh, I don't know. I can't even handle this excitement. It's so great. Now, I know that we have a lot of people in the room with Italian heritage, proud Italians. Can I hear you? Hey! So, at an auction, you guys are just gonna have to be careful because you may end up with an auction item even though you didn't really want it. So just to be careful. But we wanna see hands because we wanna get lots of money for these things. Right, Johnny? Is the Napster ready to go? All right, I'm gonna let you know what the first item up for bids. You're looking at a fire pit on stage right here. It's big, it's bold, it's beautiful. It's gonna hold a lot of wood and create some fantastic memories for you and your family. Some great summer nights. Whether it's at your home, you bring it to the camp. Look at it, it's huge. This thing is valued at $850. And we are gonna start the bidding for this puppy.
I'm gonna go 200.
We're gonna start the bidding for this at $200. I gotta make sure that I got my spotters in place here. Who have I got, who we got working for? I got Cindy, okay? Everybody's in there. All right. Here we go. So, we want to see a lot of money for this fire pit. This thing is huge. It's not the little cheap one you're going to find, you know, at Walmart or whatever. This is amazing. So, $200. Who wants it? $200. I saw somebody before. They had their, yes, we got a hand there? Yes? 200. 250. Do I hear 250 over here? Three. Do I hear 300? 300 over here. This lady over here wants it. $650. Think of the summertime. 650. I got it over here. Yes. 700. Do we hear 700? $700. 700. 700. I got $650. 650 going once. 650 going twice. Sold. Congratulations. Thank you. $650. Oh, so many great memories are going to be created with this fire pit. Thank you so much. All right. Where are the Toronto Maple Leaf fans at? Don't be embarrassed. You're having a good year. Come on. Let's see the pride. Blue and white, blue and white. All right, listen to this, gang. We got two Leaf tickets for you. First of all, you know that if you walk into Toronto, any game, the thing's sold out, right? So for Leaf tickets, even if they're not for you, you know a Leaf fan that's gonna want this. These are two tickets. It's situated in the lower bowl section, and it's for any game for the 2013-2014 season. So you get to pick which game you wanna go to. They are valued at $500. We are gonna start the bid at $250. Do I see 250? Where's my Toronto Maple Leaf fan? 250, I need 300. 300 over here, 350. 350, 400, do I see 400, 450. Can I get 450 over in the back? 500, 500, 500 here, 550. 550, can I get $600, $600 for the tickets. These are the Leafs, any game you want, $600. Two tickets, it's for the Leafs, 600. Do I hear 650? 650, it's any game the rest of the season. You could see them play a good team. $650, do we hear 650? 650, lower bowl, lower bowl. $650, 650, do I hear seven? $700 over here, do we hear 750? 750, now the true blue and white's coming out. $750, two Leaf tickets, any game, 750. No, 700 then, 700 going once, 700 going twice. Sold, $700, woohoo! Absolutely outstanding, enjoy that. That is gonna be one heck of an evening. All right, one more item up for grabs in our live auction. This is unbelievable. We've got four NHL tickets. This package is valued at $1,000, a G-note. Buffalo Sabres versus the Boston Bruins.
Bruins, Sabres.
Ding, ding. Hey, Bruins, Stanley Cup finalists last year, correct? This is gonna be an outstanding game. It's being played at First Niagara Center in Buffalo on December 19th. December 19th, Sabres and Bruins. I know, I don't even have to tell you, perfect Christmas gift for somebody, right? Think about it right now. Who do you know, who wants to go see this? It also includes one night accommodation, okay? Transportation's not included, but what a Christmas gift for the fans. Oh, okay. I know you're thinking, okay, Jim, yeah, sure, I'm in. We're not done. We're not done. It also includes a meet and greet with Marcus Foligno. It's going to be a fantastic evening, and we are going to start the bid at $500, just $500. I got $500 here, $550. Do I hear six? $600. $600 over there. Do I hear $650? Six worth $1,000. $650. Do I hear seven? $700. Seven over here. Do we hear $750? $750, do I hear eight? I need $800, guys. This is an amazing package. You are gonna have one heck of an evening. $800, $800. You got your accommodations. Think Bruins, Sabres, $800. I know you're excited, were you bidding? He's just excited, he's fired up. $800, 800, yes, we hear 800, do we hear 850? $850, $900. Let's get up to that 1,000 if we can, 900, 900. Do we hear nine? I gotta see a nine. I gotta see a hand somewhere. $900. Don't Marcus Foligno, the meet and greet, the one night's accommodations. $900. 875? 875, can I get 9 then? 900, can I get 925? Do it, 925? 9 and a quarter. Anybody 9 and a quarter over here, 950? 950. Let's do it, 1,000. Somebody's giving me a G note. Let's do it, come on. This is for Paul, this is for the family. Who's gonna do it? 950, 975? 975 over here? 975, okay, 1,000. Who's doing it? $1,000, $1,000. Are we going up? 1,050, 1050, 1050, 1050. $1,000 going once then, $1,000 going twice. Sold, $1,000. Woo! Oh my gosh, thank you so much. Thank you to all our winners. You can actually go to the back section. They've got, you can pay Visa, MasterCard, check, debit back there. Absolutely outstanding. All right, very exciting. My God, you guys are so great. Thank you so much. And I'm gonna get Natalie to come up next. She is going to announce the winners very shortly of the silent auction. So the sheets are now being picked up for the silent auction. Silent auction is closed. The last half of the silent auction now closed. Whew. What an evening. Don't forget there's still some dessert up here, still some fresh fruit. Fantastic items for you.
Hi, everybody. We're going to do the last half of the silent auction items. So here goes. The Bose System Molson and Pat Collins donation goes to Shelley Eddy. The beautiful Red Door original painting from Cynthia Chataway goes to Patty Rondina. The gift certificate for Tommy's Not Here, a wonderful restaurant in Sudbury, goes to someone Inglis.
Jennifer Inglis.
So Patty Rondina is over there. And Shelley Eddy is. Shelley is in the black and white dress. The Secret Garden, the mixed media painting by Mark Gregg, is Bonnie Gattoni. Bonnie, where are you? Okay. The Crystal Brandy Snifters, again goes to Bonnie Gattoni. The Christmas Vacation Framed Print by Paul Wandsworth is Darren Kirkwood. Darren? The handcrafted glass cheese board goes to Lori McDonald. I should have brought my glasses. No, I'm good. The handcrafted oak wooden clock, Robert Chaput. The Wine with Everything gift basket, Donna Tramontini. Is Donna still here? Donna's my sister-in-law, so.
Okay, you know.
But she. Did she go? Yeah? Okay. Okay, we'll might go with the last. The Preserve Your Life basket of treats from Jerry Falcioni and friend, Donna Tramontini. The gourmet food basket from Lori Lucian, Tina Gattoni. The Cheers Wine gift basket, Connie Conlon. Connie? Okay.
Okay.
Over there. One season ticket to the Sudbury Wolves, donated by Brian Barrow, is Terry Gattoni. Buon Appetito Italian Food Basket. Maisie Bernard. The karaoke studio party is a woman I work with, so Jane Bauer. The Cessna float plane ride for 1 hour with John Eddy is Al Kadiyan. The white crocheted blanket by Janet Henry is Jerry Tarnopolsky. The Old Man Santa by Brigitte Koronovich is Estelle Lalonde. Estelle Lalonde? The White Throw Blanket, donated by Carolyn Gord, is Margaret
Dupuis.
Margaret Dupuis? The Mother of Pearl Necklace is Tiffany Gagan. Tiffany? The Let's Party Beer Basket. Tina Gattoni. Pamper Yourself Spa Gift Basket from A Look Above is Dan Jeanvaux. Is Dan here? The Girls Night Out Basket. Bonnie Gattoni. The handcrafted glass charms is Heather Jessam Falcioni. Heather? Is Heather Falcioni here? So we have a change in the winner for the iPad. It's Estelle Lalonde.
Wait, I gotta stretch it out.
Sorry. Sorry. So we have a change in the espresso coffee pot. It's Anna Morrison. Okay, Anna.
Who's having a good time? Four people are gonna come. Who's having a good time? Oh my gosh, what a celebration this has been. There's still more to come. Big hearts to you, sweetheart. And even afterwards, there's gonna be some dancing going on, so feel free to stick around. I know Gracie's ready, she's already dancing. She can't stop dancing. Dancing on the ceiling. Well, you know who else is celebrating 5-0 next month? It's Paul. Absolutely. And seeing as we're here for a celebration, we're all together, why don't we sing happy birthday?
Happy birthday to you.
Sing it, Holly.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Ladies and gentlemen, if we can get your attention right up here to center stage, I'd like to ask Andrea Falcioni to come up here and say a few words. Ladies and gentlemen, Andrea.
Okay, I'm gonna try and get through this. on behalf of my family, we'd like to thank all of you for being here with us and for us tonight. Your presence is truly a blessing. Shit. Sorry, Mom.
You got it, Andrea.
We'd like to thank anyone who did anything to help make this night possible. We were just told to show up, so a lot of this was a major surprise for us. And I know at this point we don't know the half of it, what people did, so I'm not gonna start listing for fear of forgetting anyone. We'd like to thank our amazing friends and family for creating and organizing Paul's Basta Party. I know it's been so much work and you've been crazy busy right from the start. There are no adequate words to describe how we feel. So we will just say that we love you. Some of you already know I've been quite nervous ever since the committee came over and told us about this party, and even more nervous to come here tonight. Paul, on the other hand, wasn't nervous, because he's always up for any party. It's such a great idea when it's for someone else, but when the shoe's on the other foot, it's not an entirely comfy feeling. Saying that this is a humbling experience is an understatement. Giving of your hard-earned money and precious time to help us out is incredible and heartwarming, to say the least. We'd like to thank all those who bought tickets even though they couldn't make it, and those who bought tickets even when they were sold out, and those who bought tickets at their own self-appointed inflated price. Personally, to my Dante and Grace, we love you times infinity. And I'd like to thank my husband for his great attitude right from the very beginning of this journey. I'm not sure how I'd be functioning if you were anything different. So to all of you, we are forever grateful for your kindness, generosity, love, and prayers. And may all of it return to you tenfold. And as Paul says, live, laugh, love, and pay it forward.
You're all awaiting this with bated breath. Oh, where to start? Well, everything my wife said pretty well. It is an overwhelming feeling, to say the least, to have that kind of support. When I walked in here, when I rolled in here tonight, I got inside the hall and I thought to myself, holy shit, what the hell am I gonna do? So my immediate reaction was to stand up. I don't know why, just wave to the crowd like I'm the goddamn queen or something. Look at all these people, oh my God. I guess all I'd like to say is a big thank you to someone who wasn't said thank you to, and that's my wife. Woo! Even though I'm an exemplary patient, Not all the time, dear. Don't squeeze that hard. Oh, your nails are digging into my skin now. No, I'm just kidding. My wife, Andrea, has been a rock. Has been a rock to my family, my kids, myself. And like she said, without each other, we couldn't do this journey. And that's the way I look at this. I mean, it's a journey, right? So who cares where you start and who cares where you end up? It's all about the journey. And I've seen enough love to last me a lifetime in the last, 3-4 months? What is it, 3-4 months, Andrea?
Yeah.
My friend Norm, who's, I don't think he's here now. Norm, are you still here?
Right here.
Norm Blanchard.
Right here.
Norm came to visit me one day and we were talking about, and I've been, all my life, been quite involved with the church and stuff like that. And you guys know, I'm Roman Catholic. And, you know, I drink enough for Roman Catholic anyways. Norm came over for a visit and we had a really nice talk. And Norm, I consider Norm, other than being just a fabulous friend, and a pretty wise guy. And Norm said to me that night, he said one thing that really caught me. He said, if I go somewhere, I'm proud to be Roman Catholic. I'm proud to talk about my religion. What I need is I need to see God wherever I go. And it was in, you know, relation to another conversation that we're having, and he had said, I need to see God wherever I go. And Norm, if whoever doesn't know, Norm works at the hospice, the Valley Hospice. And Norm told me that he sees God every day. And I thought, how profound is that? Because since we've been doing this journey, that's what I've been seeing every day. Whether it be at the cancer center, or just at the hospital, or just seeing the results of this this event. I truly, truly believe that God works in wondrous ways. And I hope he blesses all of you. And thank you.
Okay, let's play with you start. Now it's time for karaoke.
Get ready to dance, it's coming up shortly. Goodbye, Joe, you gotta go a mile. The son of a gun, I'm gonna have big fun on the bio. The Gemini, cut these cocky leg on the road. But tonight I'm gonna see my share. Big guitar, fill through jar, dressed in style, go hog wild, me oh my oh. Son of a gun, I'm gonna have big fun on the bio. Oh, Jambalaya, confish pie, big fun on the bio. Oh, Jambalaya, confish pie, big fun on the bio. Oh, tonight I'm gonna see my show on the bio. Son of a gun, I'm gonna have big fun on the bio. I'm son of a gun, I'm gonna have big fun on the bio.
As soon as John called me and asked me if I would be a part of this evening, it was a done deal. I wouldn't have missed this for the world. I love this guy, and I love his wife, and I love his kids, and thank you to all of you for making this evening so absolutely memorable and fantastic, and just words can't describe what a great evening it was. There was so much work that went into it. Thank you to the organizing committee. Thank you to all of you for showing up. Thank you to the staff here and to all that gave their time. We are going to keep the party going, the dancing's going, and just a special note as well, if you have won items that you have not paid for yet, please, if you want to go do it at the back, they're taking Visa, MasterCard, cash, debit, and again, from the bottom of our hearts, thank you so much for making tonight so memorable. God bless, and drive safely.
You are not.